El Paso is opening up 2012. I've gotten the first songs are coming out in 2013. I'm starting to get new acts. Dij introduces me to his brothers now officially.
Those are his real bros?
Yeah.
1-2-5?
1-2-5. Sid and Ray, the third member was a friend, but two-thirds are my brother Dij. Yeah.
Have they done a song with Dij?
Yeah. So that's the first like song we ever did when I when I met them. The day we met them, we did a song. It was called Can't Take It. So it had Dij on it. Dij rapped and sang. Because, you know,
Dij is a crazy rapper.
He's a crazy rapper. Then the next day, Sage came by to the studio, heard the song, and was like, I have to be in this song.
Sage?
Yes. So she ad-libbed on top of that song. She did ad-libs and she did like an outro. Like she was in the hook as well.
125, Sydney. I'm just a young hunter looking for that Pocahontas. Every time I rhyme, I feel like a menace riding up on all of these Hondas. 125, a killer nigga. We go blind. I'm feeling like Ray Charles on cloud nine. I'm just being me. A young nigga with big dreams and big visions. Getting money's the big goal, my premonition. But empty pockets, my big foe, my inhibition. Cause see, I started wishing, but now it's all a mission. They put this music shit on lock, call it submission. Keep these rappers wishing, this ain't no wallet flipping. Keep all these new school rappers stuck on tuition. This is the prep,
no
bitches.
Naweza come through the easy time yote bila hata kupiga tizi. Palipopote nikirime na jenga CV. Hivi ndivyo siudu kuonekana daily kwa TV. Na CD zetu zinasikizwa na mabibi. When you mkido chafua kwenye tuki floss. Of course Kriuli hype K2 na Ibiza. Maheta watadisa pia one by one kasiza. Skiza ulimi na teleza kamkializa. Nishaborozina toka DI minjo rhyme wizard. Walithani wako kwa mwangaza kumbe wako kwa giza. Itabidi tumwashangaza na hii track ni katiza.
No matter how hard I try to be me.
So that was like the first song I ever did with 125. It was called Can't Take It.
Can't Take It?
Yes.
Nice.
Can't Take It.
Did they shoot a video?
No, they never shot a video, but we performed it. We used to perform it a lot. Because now I understand the dynamics of working Half-Life. Sage has pulled me into the band now to be doing Half-Life as well. So now we're experimenting with a lot of.
So now you're in two bands, you're in Mazoni's band and you're in Sage's band.
I think that time by that time Nisha exit.
Yeah, Mazoni. Okay.
So I'm no longer in over there because that was around when we started doing a lot of like performances. It was 2013, 2014, That's when like now Sage's live shows, Ziende, working on the album. And now clientele base is starting to grow.
Like who is there?
Cause now go to 2013 and you have even people like Susan Owio coming through. And don't forget that
to El Paso.
Yeah.
Your bedroom studio.
Yeah.
That thing I've seen life.
That place people came to that place like I remember one time.
That means it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, if you have the good music, people will come to wherever you are.
So I was getting surprised because see now, even though I'm playing an engineering role on some of the music, I'm not actually like producing. Guys just want to come and just also like record vocals over there. So I remember one time Octo was doing a collab with MI. And MI happened to be in town. So
for maybe Coke Studio or something.
Yeah. Now these guys are knocking at my door at 11 p.m. usiku. Wameleta MI El Paso. Wameleta MI El Paso to record the collabo. He did that. He did a collabo with MI. He even shot a video for it, but Nini was not. But MI wasn't on the video. but there's a collab he did with Emma. I just engineered, I didn't produce the song. I just recorded vocals and mixed and mastered like the track, because that's some of the, I'm playing a role for engineering
in
Octo's music.
And yeah.
So yeah, I saw he show up 11 usiku.
I am like
yeah, Buddha to make him could record. Say at that time again and sai. So put on the beat, and I wrote his verse and recorded Kaishia.
In El Paso. I love it.
El Paso, El Paso had vibes. too much vibes in El Paso. I think it was the whole thing of like I was also feeling like I mean such a free space where creatively also we're not listening to a lot of what's going on outside. It's just like, so nothing is influencing what we come up with. It's just, we're just here. This is the vibe that we're going for. However it comes out.
Well, let me ask you, when you start recording music, what do you normally start with? What's your process?
Like I said, mostly to be melodical.
So like, what do? You play a piano tune?
Like a melody will come to my head. Like most of these tracks have always started from a melodical point. It's very few times that the beat started. So like, I remember like So Alive just came out from such a leak. So like I first got that like licks, so like that melody in my head. Listen, like, da 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 down down. Because I'm like, okay, that sounds like could be like a track that could be like maybe soundtrackish to someone. So like, so first comes the melody. Then I look for the chords, so I know the chords will be. So that would be the beginning of that. So the piano work comes first, on like on that type of a track.
Hey, because I was like, where is it going? But now when you played with the chords, I'm just like, okay, nice.
So that's what would come first to me, if melody first. Because I think I'm thinking about it from like a singer's point of view. Where a singer will get a melody and put words into it, or just simply seeing a melody that already has words. So for me, the melody will come and I'll look for an instrument to express it. I could play it, or I could just like maybe get the chords from it and now
work from that.
See how do I twist it, how do I take it far and stuff like that. So for me, always melody first, then after melody will come in the drums. How will the drums be, what kind of bass do I need to play? Do I need a live bass on this? Do I need a live guitarist? What do I need to make it, to bring it to life? But I've always been more working on the keys. To me, piano is always like the first place I'll go.
Me and you have not worked together. Even me, that's my default.
Piano is your place in the answer.
And then strings,
it's a kambadae. And like just the whole structure of the beat to come. So now El Paso, I'm experimenting with all types of music. This is where now I feel like I'm most experimental. I don't have to please anybody. I'm creating a sound that maybe people can identify to, because there's a lot of freedom. So with El Paso, there was many recordings. Hold up, let me first look at this more Kenya, because there were songs, so many songs from El Paso. And don't forget at this time, I'm doing both El Paso and Love Child Records.
So you've already joined Love Child Records?
So when Waire had a studio that he was running in Nairobi West. So when I left Homeboys, I was like, I'm not really looking to be employed, but I could collaborate. If you need to do your own projects, come to your studio, let's do it, but I also need to run my own little thing at the same time. So that's what we would do. So if Wide had a project, I'm down in Nairobi West at the studio. So which was the genesis of even me meeting Suzanne at first, because we met with Suzanne at Nairobi West. Wide brought her to do a song for UNEP. So now you see, I'm starting to get introduced to jingles and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So we do a song for UNEP. Nani, like, she likes it. We do another song still. It was called Seo. It was about like tribalism and all that. And
this, so that was the UNEP one?
No. The UNEP one was just like an anthem, a song to thank them for, because she was the rep. She was like a rep.
Like the ambassador or something?
Yeah. So a song for them for the theme of what they're doing. And then now she did another song called Seo, which is just like Seo, Kosa Langu, Kwa, Kabila Langu. And that's when now we brought in Polycarp. Polycarp played guitars on that song for Seo, because it was very acoustic. I had a beat for it, but we decided not to use the beat. And that's when now Suzanne looked for a percussion guy, Kamchukua Kamtahadi El Paso, for us to now record the percussion in my bedroom, yeah, for that song.
Tumeishi kama ndugu na dada, tumeishi kama ndugu na dada, pepo mbaya inatutenganisha, pepo mbaya inatutenganisha. Sio kosa langu kuwa kabila langu, sio kosa langu kuwa kabila lako, sio kosa langu kuwa kabila langu, sio kabila lako. Yero chopo minyo riedo, wone goyo mbulu kijendio riedo, ochopo sama koro kilando nga monoyo, dano ringo mweke deni kukuchako koko tukore. Ochopo sama koro kilando nga monoyo, dano ringo mweke deni kukuchako koko tukore. Kidi bare, kidi, kidi, kidi bare, kite bare, kidi bare, kite bare. Sio kosa langu kuwa kabila langu, sio kosa langu kuwa kabila lako, sio kosa langu kabila langu, sio kosa langu kabila langu.
So pale hivi wase wanacheki tu, Suzanne na pull up na range, alafu anatoa madrums huko na
anaingia huko,
anaingia hapo kwa kaploti fulani kutengeneza mziki. Guys used to ask me like, what do you do?
Wote wanakuja huku kwa nini?
Wase, wanafanya nini huku? Because now you're seeing like, mara you chill, you see Suzanne huyo ame pull up, unaona Nameless ame pull up, unapata Juliani ndio huyo. Because now Juliani is coming to El Paso.
Because Juliani is now working on One Day.
Yes, he's working on the album, which was now going to be the album Exponential Potential.
Oh yes, actually the album Exponential Potential.
Because you see, Julian used to name his next album
from a single from the previous.
So now, being that Exponential was the single from
Pulpit. So hold on, his father was Mta Mentality, and yes, then he had
Pulpit Kwa Street.
Pulpit Kwa Street, oh yes, which was a song of the thing.
Pulpit Kwa Street is what had Exponential Potential. So now from
now
he's doing the album Exponential Potential, which has
the song One Day.
It has One Day. It has Jehovah.
Oh, you okay? Hold on. We'll talk. Hey, Juliani, you may find your mob.
And I think even
before that,
when we are still doing El Paso, when I'm still at El Paso, I'm coming here. Giuliani now is a neighbor. Actually, funny enough, you see where this studio is situated?
Yeah.
Giuliani lived next door.
Oh, crazy.
So Giuliani used to live next door where my neighbor is living right now.
Mm-hmm.
Here used to live a lawyer friend of his called Mokesi.
Yeah, and Mokesi was also doubled up as manager.
Yes. So Mokesi used to live here. So I think when Mokesi moved, a friend of ours called Bob Mushiri took up this space now and created the studio and then also set up Blinky in the other room.
Mm.
So when Bob decided to move, he was like, now Blinky cannot be left with the space alone. So he looked, they were looking for someone, and then Bob happened to know that I was looking for a studio at that time. It's just like, yo, we have a studio, staff, all you need to do is come with the equipment.
Mm.
So that's how I ended up here. But now Giuliani used to live just here. So remember, he bought equipment to...
for the KCCC tour.
Yeah, KCCC tour.
ICJ.
Yeah, so he has the equipment in the house. So all I would do is come with my laptop and would create in the house. So before he even started creating Exponential Potential tracks, we did two songs in his house during that El Paso period. And the first song that we did was Utawala.
Shut up.